We gather together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the secret mysteries. With humble heart together we say, I confess to Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Grant us, O merciful God, protection in our weakness, that we who keep the memorial of the Holy Mother of God may, with the help of her intercession, rise up from our iniquities through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the second book of Chronicles. After the death of Jehoiada, the princes of Judah came and paid homage to King Joash. And the king then listened to them. They forsook the temple of the Lord, the God of their fathers, and began to serve the sacred poles and the idols. And because of this crime of theirs, wrath came upon Judah and Jerusalem. Although prophets were sent to them to convert them to the Lord, the people would not listen to their warnings. Then the Spirit of God possessed Zechariah, son of Jehoiada, the priest. He took his stand above the people and said to them, God says, why are you transgressing the Lord's commands so that you cannot prosper? Because you have abandoned the Lord, he has abandoned you. But they conspired against him, and at the king's order, they stoned him to death in the court of the Lord's temple. Thus, King Joash was unmindful of the devotion shown him by Jehoiada, Zechariah's father, and slew his son. And as Zechariah was dying, he said, may the Lord see and avenge. At the turn of the year, a force of Arameans came upon against Joash. They invaded Judah and Jerusalem, did away with all the princes of the people, and sent all their spoil to the king of Damascus. Though the Aramean force came with few men, the Lord surrendered a very large force into their power, because Judah had abandoned the Lord, the God of their fathers. So punishment was meted out to Joash. After the Arameans had departed from him, leaving him in grievous suffering, his servants conspired against him because of the murder of the son of Jehoiada, the priest. He was buried in the city of David, but not in the tombs of the kings. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Forever, I will maintain my love for my servant.
Forever, I will maintain my love for my servant.
I have made a covenant with my chosen one. I have sworn to David, my servant. Forever will I confirm your posterity and establish your throne for all generations.
Forever I will maintain my love for my servant.
Forever I will maintain my kindness toward him, and my covenant with him stands firm. I will make his posterity endure forever, and his throne as the days of heaven.
Forever I will maintain my love for my servant.
If his sons forsake my law and walk not according to my ordinances, if they violate my statutes and keep not my commands.
Forever I will maintain my love for my servant.
I will punish their crime with a rod and their guilt with stripes. Yet my mercy I will not take from him, nor will I belie my faithfulness.
Forever I will maintain my love for my servant. Please all stand.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Your words, O Lord, give joy to my heart. Your teaching is light to my eyes. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "No one can serve two masters. He will either hate one and love the other, or be devoted to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and mammon. Therefore, I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or drink, or about your body, what you will wear. Is not life more than food, and the body more than clothing? Look at the birds in the sky. They do not sow or reap. They gather nothing into barns. Yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are not you more important than they? Can any of you, by worrying, add a single moment of your lifespan? Why are you anxious about clothes? Learn from the way the wild flowers grow. They do not work or spin, but I tell you that not even Solomon in all his splendor was clothed like one of them. If God so clothes the grass on the field, which grows today and is thrown into the oven tomorrow, will he not much more provide for you? You of a little faith, so do not worry and say, what are we eat, or what are we to drink, or what we are to wear? All these things the pagans seek. Your heavenly Father knows that you need them all. But seek first the kingdom of God in his righteousness, and all these things will be given you besides. Do not worry about tomorrow. Tomorrow will take care of itself. Sufficient for a day is its own evil. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Today, as we gather to conclude the 11th week in ordinary time, and we celebrate today the memorial of the Blessed Virgin Mary, surely, my dear brothers and sisters, we are all in His presence to continue our journey with conviction and determination. We live together and we walk together with faith and trust in Him. Our gospel today, my dear brothers and sisters, tells us about our situation that everybody may experience. We cannot deny the condition that we have in our day-to-day living, and that is to worry. It is negative condition or emotion, but it is real to experience in our life every day. To worry about. Marami po tayong iniisip, marami po tayong inaalala, at mas malala, maraming bumabagabag at tayo'y nababalisa sa ating buhay. And many instances of our lives, we are succumbed to this kind of emotion or condition. And we are all affected by a society preoccupied with a pleasure-seeking lifestyle, unavoidable offered to us by our society. Again, preoccupied society with a pleasure-seeking lifestyle that is offered to us by our society, unavoidable for to offer to all of us. We cannot escape from this, mother, brothers, and sisters. Instead, sabi nga po, sige na lang, we go along with, makikisabay na lang tayo. That is why our mind is full of preoccupation. Ano ang ating gagawin? Ano ang ating dapat gawin? Saan tayo kukuha? Paano ito mangyayari, paano ito matatanggap, at marami pang tanong sa ating isipan. Our minds full of preoccupation, mga bumabagabag sa ating isipan, bumabagabag sa ating buhay, na kung minsan mga minamahal na kapatid, nagdudulot ng pagkabalisa ng kung minsan sa ating buhay, at hindi lang minsan, sa mga bagay-bagay, parang doon umiikot ang buhay natin. Doon tayo nagiging balisa sa mga material na bagay na meron tayo at gusto pa nating matanggap sa buhay natin. Our gospel today, Jesus directly mentioned, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or drink, about your body, what you will wear. Is not life more than food and body more than clothing? To translate it, my dear brothers and sisters, in existential way, this is to worry about money, our work, our food, and clothing. To sum it all, paano tayo makakasurvive ng buhay natin? Paano tayo magpapatuloy sa ating buhay? We still tend to worry about these things.
hindi po nawawala ito sa ating isipan. Kaya nga po tayo dumudulog sa ating Panginoon para matugunan ang mga ito sa ating isipan na bumabagabag sa atin. We are all worries about these things. Money, work, food, clothing, and many more. In modern times, my brothers and sisters, that we are right now, people worry more than ever before. Masabi po natin, ang mga tao noon ay hindi, parang hindi balisa. Pero ngayon, parang lahat ng tao ay balisa. Lahat nararamdaman yung pagiging bumabagabag o nagkakaroon ng bagabag sa buhay. My dear brothers and sisters, this is our life today. The information age has produced an age of anxiety. Bumabagabag, tayo nag-aabala. But Jesus turned the table about this. Don't worry about this every day. Don't worry about these everyday issues in our lives. Ano daw ang kailangan natin? Have faith and full trust in Him. Have faith in God. Give our full trust to Him. Your needs will be provided. Umasa tayo sa Panginoon. Magtiwala tayo sa Panginoon. Ialay natin sa Panginoon ang lahat na ito. Bibigyan tayo ng ating pangangailangan at hindi tayo mababagabag sa ating buhay. St. Paul would say, my dear brothers and sisters, do not worry about things, but in everything, prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. The roots of worry can find their way into our hearts. And almost unnoticed, when we begin to seek security and anything other than God, akala po natin bahagi na ng buhay natin ang mga ito. But again, we are reminded of today that our life, it must be aligned with God, focused to Him. Tiwala at pananampalataya ang kailangan natin. Because kung hindi po natin to bibigyan pansin sa buhay natin, we are creating in our interior division of in ourselves. That Jesus calls us today in this situation, as mentioned in our gospel today, you serve two masters. As the Lord tells us today, you cannot serve both God and Mammon. Hindi mo pwedeng pagsabayin ang dalawang ito. That's why we are reminded of our priorities in our decision in our lives. So therefore, if we prioritize God in our life, we have conviction and determination that the Spirit of God, His blessing, will be in our hands. God bestowed His graces upon us if we have full trust and priority in our life, in our journey every day. That is why, my dear brothers and sisters, it is impossible to find peace with undivided heart. Mahirap pong maging mapayapa ang buhay kung maraming iniisip. Kung hati ang ating isipan at ating damdamin, hindi po tayo makakatagpo ng kapayapaan. And we are all reminded today, being worried people, being worried community, this being worry, my dear brothers and sisters, a symptom of a deep problem, which is lack of trust in God or weakness of faith. Kung ganito ang ating nararamdaman, kung ito ang ating inuugali, kahit tayo nagdarasal, kulang pa rin, hindi pa rin sapat ang ating pagtitiwala at pananampalataya sa Diyos. Again, my dear brothers and sisters, if we experience this, kung tayo ay palaging balisa, walang kapayapaan at walang kaayusan ng buhay natin because we focus on ourselves in material things, hindi po natin masasabi buo ang aking pananampalataya at pagtitiwala sa Diyos. That is why put our trust in Him. Gear with faith every day as we journey. Because as our gospel mentioned today, and Jesus assures us, we are all significant. We are all great. And we are all blessed in the eyes of God. Like Mary's word in the annunciation of Angel Gabriel to him, siya po ay nagulumihanan, nagtaka na siya at natakot nung sinabi ng anghel kay Maria, ikaw Maria, maging ina ng anak ng Diyos. Si Maria kaagad natakot din, nagkaroon din ng ganitong pagkabalisa. But the words of Mary, iniiwan sa atin. At ito rin dapat ang ating sabihin, may it be done to me according to your word. Amen.
Please all stand.
My dear brothers and sisters, the gospel calls us to be single-minded in our service of God. May our prayers to the Father express that quality of trust and devotion. And every petition we say, Father, we trust our cares to you.
Father, we trust our cares to you.
The church leaders may devote themselves tirelessly to furthering of God's kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, we trust our cares to you.
That we may realize the need to show care and concern for the poor and the needy, let us pray to the Lord.
Father, we thrust our cares to you.
That we may live in complete submission to the will of God and never become anxious concerning matters that are not worth worrying about. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, we thrust our cares to you.
That the sick may experience the love of God through the compassion of those who care for life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, we thrust our cares to you.
That the faithful departed may share in Christ's victory over death. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, we trust our cares to you.
In the silence of our hearts, let us now pray for our personal intentions. Father, we trust in you. May we never set our hearts on material things, but on your loving providence. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for the goodness we have received, the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of the human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness you have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of the human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please stand.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
As we honor the memory of the mother of your son, we pray, O Lord, that the oblation of this sacrifice may by your grace make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds and exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to earth's ends, you have done great things and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you look on the lowliness of your handmaid, you give us through her the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May your voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your spirit upon them like a dewfall, so they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of a new and eternal covenant, which you poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life in the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have made us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ may be gotten to one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, the church spread throughout the world and bring it to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Jose our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that to the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints you have visited throughout the ages, we merit to be coerced to eternal life and to praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
My dear brothers and sisters, this is Jesus, the very source of our life. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof,
but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ give us the effortless.
Thank you. Please all stand.
Let us pray. Having been made partakers of eternal redemption, we pray, O Lord, that we who commemorate the mother of your Son may glorify in your fullness of your grace and experience its continued increase for our salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And the Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorify the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Maria, ni panang ama.